Hello, and welcome to this training video on using the VSWR and DTF application on the Viavi AVX-10K test set. In this video, we will be discussing the basic concepts of VSWR and DTF, the VSWR calibration process, setup and the cable selection tab. We will review the provided cable settings and walk through adding a user-defined cable. We will then run through the procedures for testing an antenna and a cable. Let's start with a basic overview of the differences between VSWR and DTF. Voltage standing wave ratio measures how efficiently an antenna utilizes the power fed to it. And DTF shows where a cable fault lies along the line from the AVX-10K. After turning on your test set, open the test tools ribbon and select the VSWR DTF application. Before taking measurements, the calibration procedure needs to be performed. The tools needed include a cable, a standard short, and a 50-ohm load. If you purchased a kit, you should have this equipment. Start the calibration procedure, select external standards and then follow the instructions provided to measure and open, with cable attached, then measure with a standard short, then measure with the 50-ohm load. Finally, save the measured values using the Save as Default option. Now, let's move to the selection of the cable type that you are measuring. Click on the Cable DB tab and choose the cable being tested from the provided list. If your specific cable is not provided, you can add a cable type by clicking the Add button and entering a name, cable velocity, and cable loss as measured in dB per 100 feet. The cable velocity is usually between 0.6 and 0.9 or may be specified as a percentage between 60 and 90%. These values are specified by the cable manufacturer or can be researched on the internet if you know the cable type. With calibration complete and cable type selected, you are ready to test either an antenna or a cable. Let's look at testing an antenna, using the VSWR tab. An antenna can be tested using a measurement mode of either VSWR, to view readings as a ratio, or return loss, to view readings in decibels. This setting is usually determined by how the manufacturer has specified the antenna. Click on the Instrument Settings button to modify this setting. The frequency band can also be limited to the range of the antenna being tested, if preferred, or you can just leave the settings to sweep from 10 to 1250 MHz. Also, when using the VSWR measurement mode, you will want to turn off the auto scale feature. This setting is found under the vertical scale option in Instrument Settings. Connect your antenna and cable to the SWR port on the AVX-10K. The VSWR application is set to run all the time. You can stop and start the capture by toggling the VSWR on and VSWR off button at the lower right. When applicable, you can use the icons just above the soft key labels to quickly find the main valley of the signal and then jump left or right to see other valleys in the signal. A good antenna will have a low VSWR ratio in the intended frequency band. Please see the manufacturer's specifications for tolerances. This application can also help determine faulty cables or connections. Click on the DTF tab. Connect your cable under test directly to the SWR port on the AVX-10K and for best results set measurement mode to VSWR and turn vertical auto scale on. If you have an open or short in the cable, it will look similar to this. The peak finder can be used to quickly locate the distance to the anomaly. The experts at Viavi Solutions are ready to answer your questions about using the AVX-10K. Send your questions or comments to americas.service@viavisolutions.com or call 1-800-835-2350.